Earlier we studied, whenever the company takes loan from the creditor gets right on the assets of the company. And when the company repays the loan, the creditor will cease to have rights on the assets of the company. And this is termed as satisfaction of charge. Do you want to know what are the provisions related to the satisfaction of charges? If yes, then do check out the full video. Friends, this is Lina Rava. I am here to discuss about the remaining sections on registration of charges. Section 82 of the Companies Act 2013 states that every company needs to report satisfaction of charge by filing application in form CHA4 to the ROC within 30 days, failing which within 300 days from the date of satisfaction, along with the form CHA10. Which state the reason for delay. For IFSC company, they have to register within 300 days without any delay form. And when the ROC gets application regarding satisfaction of charge, he will cross-check charge holder by giving him 14 days time to reply. Remember friend, if the CHA4 form already contains the signature of charge holder, then ROC will not opt for cross-check. After verification, ROC will issue CHA5, that is Certificate for Satisfaction of Charge, to the company. Next is Section 83, which empowers registrar to make entries of satisfaction and release charges, even if no application is filed by the company or the charge holder. And if ROC exercises this power, then he needs to inform affected parties within 30 days and shall issue CHA5, that is Certificate of Satisfaction, to the company. Section 84 states that whenever the company appoints or removes any manager who manages all the assets undercharged, company shall inform ROC about such appointment or removal within 30 days by filing CHA6 to the ROC. Section 85. Every company have to maintain registrar of charges in form CHA7, where all the particulars of charges registered with ROC will be kept and it will be preserved permanently. Any contract of charge needs to be preserved for 8 years from satisfaction of charge. Have you ever wondered what are the consequences for non-registration of charges? If a company contravenes any of the provisions relating to the registration of charges, then Section 86 gets attracted, which states punishment for contravention. The company shall pay fine minimum of rupees 1 lakh to maximum 10 lakh. Every officer in default shall pay fine of rupees 25,000 to 1 lakh or up to 6 months imprisonment or both. Any person who knowingly contravenes Section 77 shall be liable for fraud under Section 447. And if you don't know about Section 447, then you can check our previous video by clicking the I button. Section 87 is all about power of rectification by central government. Whenever any company makes any default in filing CHA4 or if there is any misstatement in CHA4, then the company can ask for condonation in form CHA8 to the CG. And if CG condones, then CG will issue INC28 to the company. Now the company have to submit CHA4 along with INC28 to the ROC for registration of satisfaction of charge. Thank you. How do you find my video? Comment below and let me know your valuable suggestion. And please subscribe my channel.